Welcome, Vinod ji. Tell us something about your this book, new book.
This book contains ghazals and nazms, and it has been published by a very renowned Urdu publisher called Anjuman Tarakki Urdu Hind. And the name of the book is Meri Zamin Mera Asmaa’n. Now, the Hindi version is still in the press, and it may take another 15-20 days for it to come out. The contents of the Hindi book will be the same, but there may be a slight change in the name.
What inspired you to write the book?
See, the book contains various poems on various themes. So there is nothing specific which has inspired me. I have been inspired by the world, the human beings, their sensibilities, their concerns. Therefore, these poems, they cover various aspects of human life. It may be pain, it may be love, it may be peace, it may have existential issues, it may have religious issues, especially which concern the human beings and which concerns the society. Therefore, it touches various aspects of life. And being a sensitive person, when you interact with society, they do impact you in various ways. And I have expressed my feelings and emotions through the ghazals and nazms, which form part of this book.
Being a corporate person and having such and being in a such a high profile post in Reliance, how did you get time to write such a book?
See, people always talk about time. They always say that there's a dearth of time when you are working at a very senior position. But I personally feel it's a question of priorities. Whatever time you have got, you can make best use of it. You have to prioritize your time. Since I was very keen to write, express my feelings in the form of a poetry, I did find time for that. At times, I have been writing these poems while traveling. If I am on a foreign trip, which normally takes 8 to 10 hours to reach, I'll work on at least one or two ghazals. Even if I am making domestic travel, I do make best use of that. Moreover, during holidays and all, maybe in the morning, whenever I'm fresh and free, I try to write something, or at least I try to revise it. Because the ghazal is the most difficult form of poetry. And it has to go several revisions. And therefore, you keep on working on it. Therefore, time has never been a problem.
But I heard that you took around 7 to 8 years to pin down all the ghazals and nazms.
Yes, because first of all, I told you ghazal is the most difficult form of poetry. And sky is the limit so far as ghazal writing is concerned. So when you write, basically first cut, then you keep on improving, revising, revisiting, and therefore it takes a lot of time. Number one. Number two, you can't write just like that. The thoughts come to you. They may dawn upon you one fine morning, or they may not come at all for months. Therefore, it's a question of when it comes to you, and then you start writing. Moreover, when you touch upon various topics, again, it takes time. So basically, because it's metered and very well structured, you have to be very, very careful. You have to be, you have to ensure the thoughts do convey a meaning, because so long as these feelings and emotions remain in your mind, there is no problem. The moment you plan to take it out in the public domain, then you have to work to the satisfaction of the public, and therefore you have to work hard on it. Of course, it is very time taking, very time consuming.
Your other book is in Urdu. How did you learn Urdu?
When I thought of publishing my book in Urdu, I thought it would be dishonest on my part if I don't know the script. And therefore, I started learning the script. And in the last 5-6 years, or maybe 4 years, I have started learning the script slowly and slowly. So today I can read it. Of course, writing is a bit difficult, it takes time. But once I got a feel of the script, then it wasn't that difficult to read it, to understand it. So, but again, the sky is the limit, as I said. And Urdu script is again a bit complicated. But yes, I'm still in the learning process. And I can say 60% to 65% have got a foothold on the script.
Any message in this book, any message you want to portray or you want to convey?
There is no message as such. But of course, when I am writing on ethical and moral issues, it does convey. As a human being, if a person is honest, is always a gainer. So wherever I have written on existential issues, then this is broadly the message. Otherwise, wherever it comes to other feelings like love and pain and all, my expression have been very truthful. This is what I have tried to do. So I will say an honest expression with an attempt to make it get conveyed to the reader, and I have tried to write down those thoughts and emotions with which readers can relate. So broadly, these two precautions which I took while writing. And I have not planned too much, else I would have lost spontaneity.
This book, any new book you are trying to write after this?
See, as a writer, I keep on writing. So the collections of new fresh ghazals are always there. It may take another 1 year or two before the second book. I'll say the third book goes to the press. So again, as I've said, it may take 2-3 years to work on it and make it to the satisfaction of the reader. Only then I think it goes to the press.
From being the Income Tax Commissioner, then Managing Director of National Textiles Corporation, and then being a President of Reliance Company, Anil Ambani's company. So how is the transition like? How the transition has come about?
See, your core remains the same. Wherever you are, your core remains the same. All along, my emphasis has been on work. And whatever has come to me, I've done to the best of my ability, and I've always given 100%. So when that is the basic philosophy, whether you are in a government, whether you're in a private sector, whether you are working in a taxation field, or whether you're working as a managing director of an institution or a president of a company, basic philosophy remains the same. You have to deliver. You have to do your best to deliver. For that, you have to do proper planning. So whatever you do, whether it's poetry writing or working in office or working at home or working in any other field, proper planning and it's proper conscious execution is the key. Therefore, I don't see any change, any difference in my working style, and it has been very easy for me to adjust to all these differing working environment.
All the best, Vinodji, for your books, Meri Zamin Mera Asmaa’n. Thank you very much for giving us time.
Thank you.